Thank you very much, everyone. It's a very hard act to follow from Sarah Haidar, from Bonna Ahmad, from Mohammed Al Khadra, from Russell Ahmad. It's such a pleasure to be here. Thank you, Annie Laurie, Dan Barker, and Freedom from Religion Foundation. It's such an honor for me to introduce this wonderful woman, Ensaf Haidar, really a well-deserved recipient of the Henry Zumach Freedom from Religious Fundamentalism Award for the tireless work that she's done to free her husband, Raif Badawi. And I think this award is particularly important that it's here in the United States, given the US government's persistent support of the Saudi regime, despite its brutal war in Yemen, despite its brutal assassination of the journalist Jamal Khashoggi in broad daylight at its embassy in Turkey, despite massive human rights violations that have been taking place. And like the Iranian regime, a country that I come from, to me, Saudi Arabia is fundamentally no different from ISIS. It still decapitates opponents. It crucifies people according to its so-called Sharia justice system. And because of US government support, it gets away literally with murder. And I think it's within this context, it's important to remember that it is within this context that you have someone like Raif Badawi publicly defending freedom of expression, freedom of conscience, secularism, and universal values. And for which, of course, he is paying a very heavy price. 10 years in prison, 1,000 lashes, which is torture and can kill someone. 50 of those lashes have been carried out and thankfully stopped as a result of public pressure, which is why this award and this continued pressure is so important. And not to forget his lawyer, Walid Abul Khair, who has also been sentenced, imagine, to 15 years in prison for his defense of Raif and for his human rights work. So the human cost also, we mustn't forget. Raif has been in prison for more than 6.5 years now. He hasn't had not one person visit him. He has not seen his wonderful wife and his three children for over 7 years. His youngest daughter was 4 when he last saw her, and she is 11 years old now. So this human cost is so, so great, which is what makes this Freedom from Religion Foundation Award so important, so relevant. It recognizes the heroic work of Raif Badawi, but also it recognizes the heroic work of Ensaf Haidar, who is a hero in her own right for her tireless work campaigning for justice, campaigning for accountability, and campaigning for her husband to be free, and for us never to forget Raif and all those who are languishing in Saudi prisons. She is a petite woman who is really a giant. And because of them, because of women who want to drive in Saudi Arabia, who are fighting for that, because of activists who are opposed to male guardianship rules there, because of Al-Shamri, who is an atheist who has been given the death penalty because of his atheism, because primarily of Raif and Ensaf, we see another side to Saudi medievalism and brutality. It's a human side, a universalist side, a side that really belongs in the 21st century. This prize is important because it recognizes them, it defends them, it shows solidarity with them, it stands with them, not just yesterday and today, but tomorrow and in the future until Raif is free. So ladies and gentlemen, the most wonderful, the most brilliant Ensaf Haidar.
Merci, chère Mariam. Merci beaucoup. Merci tout le monde.
سيداتي سادتي مضت أكثر من 6 سنوات وزوجي رائف بدوي يقبع خلف الزنازين الباردة بالمملكة السعودية 6 سنوات ونحن نحمل الأمل يوما ورا يوم دون أن نتعب 6 سنوات من الانتظار المستمر 6 سنوات من الأسئلة الحارقة والمؤلمة حينما يسألني أطفالي متى يعود بابا أو حينما يسألونني ماما لقد قرأت إن المجرمين هم من يقبعون بالسجن فهل أبي مجرم؟ بالله عليكم بماذا أجيبهم؟
Ladies and gentlemen, my husband Raif Badawi has been in behind the cold steel bars of the cells of Saudi Arabia for more than 6 years. 6 years we never grew tired of having hope every single day. 6 years of perpetual waiting. 6 years of painful questions such as when my children ask me, when does daddy come back? Or when they ask, mom, I heard that only criminals go to jail. Is dad a criminal? For heaven's sake, what shall my answer be?
أحمل إليكم اليوم رسالة زوجي وأطفالي الثلاثة الذين حرموا من أبيهم لا لشيء إلا لأنه مارس حقه الطبيعي في التعبير عن الرأي.
I carry to you my husband's and my 3 children's message. Those children who were denied to have their father in their life because he exercised his right to free expression.
أحمل إليكم رسالة أمل بأن أرى يوما ما زوجي رائف بدوي يقف بينكم من هذا المنبر ليخبركم عن الحرية وحقوق الإنسان ليخبركم كيف أن الحرية لا تسجن ولا تجلد ولا تعدم مهما حاولوا أو مهما تفننوا في وسائل القمع والإهانة.
I carry to you a message of hope that I will one day see Raif standing here in front of you so that he can tell you about freedom and human rights, so that he can tell you that freedom cannot be imprisoned, lashed, or given a death penalty, no matter how much they try and how far they can go in their oppression and humiliation.
أجل لقد تحدثت الكثير عن رائف كثيرا وما زلت سردت معاناته في أماكن ومناسبات عديدة وهذا كان دائما ممكنا بفضل أناس مثلكم.
Yes, I have talked about Raif much and I still do. I described his suffering in many places and occasions and this has always been possible because of people like you.
تمر اليوم 6 سنوات والمستقبل يبقى دائما مبنيا للمجهول. حتى الساعة التي في بيتي فقدت عقاربها منذ أن اعتقل رائف. جزء منا أيضا يقبع في السجن ومعاناتنا تزداد يوما بعد يوم.
Now it's been 6 years and the future is still unknown. The hands of the clock stand still at my house. Part of us is in jail and our pain grows every day.
لكننا لم نفقد الأمل بعد وهذا بفضلكم جميعا. تضامنكم هو الدعم والاعتراف الحقيقي. تضامنكم أيضا مع كل المفكرين الأحرار بالعالم العربي والإسلامي بشكل عام هو من يدعمنا أكثر.
But we haven't lost hope, and this is because of all of you. Your solidarity is the true assistance and recognition, and your advocacy for free thinkers in the Arabic and Muslim world provides us with more support.
إذا كانت الحكومات الأوروبية حقا صادقة في حربها ضد الإرهاب الإسلامي، فإن أول شيء يجب عليها فعله هو دعم الأصوات المناضلة للتطرف من داخل العالم الإسلامي. ودعم كل المدافعين عن حقوق الإنسان كما هو متعارف عليها كونيا بغض النظر عن الجنس.
If Western governments are genuinely interested in combating Islamic terrorism, then the first thing they should do is to aid the anti-radical voices within the Islamic world and all those who defend universal human rights.
إن إصرار امرأة كيبيكية أتت من كندا العظيمة لتقف الآن وتقول لكم بصوت عالي وعلى قدمين ثابتين. إن التغيير السلمي ممكن في كل الدول القمعية مع هذا الجيل الجديد جيل العولمة والإنترنت والمدونات الأفكار لم يعد من الممكن منعها أو حجبها.
It is determination that brought this human from Quebec, Canada, to stand before you and say with a loud voice and fixed feet that peaceful change is possible in all authoritarian states with this new generation, a generation of globalism, the internet and blogging, Ideas cannot be censored anymore.
إنه تغيير جديد، ثورة جديدة من المغرب وحتى جاكرتا. الشباب اليوم هم من سيجدون طبيعة المستقبل، من سيحددون طبيعة المستقبل، ويجب علينا دعمهم والوقوف بجانبهم، وهنا يكمن دوركم في المشاركة في هذا التغيير بلا استثناء.
It's a new change, a new revolution. From Morocco to Jakarta, this young generation is going to determine the nature of the future, and we must aid them and stand next to them. And this where you fit into this change.
أما المعتقلين الحقيقيين هم هؤلاء الذين يستطيعون الدفاع عن الحرية لكن لا يفعلون المعتقد.
The real prisoners are those who are capable of defending freedom and they choose not to.
سيداتي سادتي، لقد قلت لكم الكثير ولا أعتقد أن هناك شيء آخر لا تعرفونه عن قضيتنا، لكنني باختصار أود أن أقول لكم إن قضية رائف ليست قضية فردية، هي قضية مجتمع، قضية وطن. رائف بدوي حمل قضية هذا الوطن في قلبه وعبر عن هذا الهم بقلمه وبكلماته بالحبر على الورق.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have talked a great deal and I don't think there is anything you do not know about our case, but I would like to tell you in short that Raif case is not an individual issue. It's a social issue. It's an issue of a country and a homeland. Raif Badawi carried his concerns for his nation in his heart. He expressed his ideas with his pen, his words, with ink and on papers.
التغيير لن يحدث طالما تركنا الخوف يكمم أفواهنا. التغيير لن يحدث لو ظل الصمت منهجنا. يوما ما سيتوجب عليهم أن يلتزموا بالقوانين والمعاهدات الدولية لحقوق الإنسان. وهذا الحلم سيتحقق. أثق في ذلك تماما كما أثق أن رائف سيقف بينكم يوما ما هنا على هذا المنبر الكريم. وحينها سيحق لي أن أبتهج لأن يوم إطلاق سراح رائف سيكون يوما عظيما للحرية. سيكون عيد الكل أنصار العالم.
Change will not be possible if we let fear censor us. It will not be possible if silence continues to be our approach. There will be a day when they will need to follow the international laws and treaties of human rights. This dream will become a reality. I have trust in that. And I have trust that Raif will stand before you one day, and then I will rightfully be delighted. The day of his release will be a great day for freedom and its supporters worldwide.
سيداتي وسادتي، شكراً لحضوركم اليوم لتتويجي بهذه الجائزة المرموقة في مدينة سان فرانسيسكو، مدينة الحرية.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here and honoring me with this prize here in San Francisco, a city of freedom.